What up, though? And welcome back to Old School Hip Hop Head Reel Reacts. I also have another YouTube channel called Reels Reactions. And on that YouTube channel, it's 99% old school golden era hip hop. So if you're ever in the mood to watch some old school hip hop reactions, all you have to do is go to my homepage, click this link I have in a banner right here that says Reels Reactions, and voila, you back in the golden era. Alright, so before I go any further, let me say, welcome back to Reels. So, on Sundays, baby. So this is a continuation of the reaction that I already did for the original version of All Night Long by the Mary Jane Girls, right? So, like I was saying during that video, yo, that original song produced and written by Rick James is just mad hip-hop, son. Like, it's just so many elements of hip-hop in that beat. It's just a classic hip-hop beat at this point, you know what I mean? Or I should say a classic hip-hop sample has been used so many different times. So not only was it big in the actual world of hip-hop, but it was also big in urban R&B, which is what I call my generation of R&B. Because people like Mary J. and Jodeci and people like that, 112, all them motherfuckers, that shit was mad hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, yo, enough talking. Let's get to this shit. This is the motherfucking queen of my generation when it comes to that R&B soul shit, yo. This is Mary J. motherfucking Blige. I love Mary J. Blige. If I was out and Mary J. Blige was in harm's way, I would definitely step in front of the harm for Mary J. Blige. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm about to go for mine for Mary J., you know what I'm saying? But anyway, this is All Night Long, yo. Let's jump right into it. Funky. Funky. That boom bap is knocking. Woo! See, this version is heavy into the piano, I see. The other one wasn't a heavy piano. The original, I should say. Okay. Ooh, there's work to do. I wanna get real close to you. I wanna get you with the mood. All the things you want to do. Just relax and I'll take care of you. Anytime you want me, I'm saying that I love you every day. And I know that you love me. Come into my bedroom, honey. What I got will make you spend money. Oh. Of course. Now, was this when Mary J. was with was she ever with Bad Boy? But, you know, her and Puffy, like, you know, they connected, you know what I'm saying? So I want. She said, "What I got will make you spend money." In the original version, the girl says, "What I got is better than money." And the girl says, "You know, when you come up to the roof," she says, "when you come up to the bedroom," or something like that. So they changed the vocals around a little bit, but not much, not much at all. But anyway, let's let Mary J. keep blowing.
Chance, I can still show you romance. I know that you still savor for my flavor, babe. So stop playing hard to get. Let's make love like we
All right, so Mary J. fucked up. That's what this song is about. You know, she done did something foul. You know what I'm saying? She trying to make things right. So she looking to have some makeup sex, because some people say, like crazy bitches do, like makeup sex is the best sex or whatever. Like, that's why they be starting fights and all this bullshit. Whatever. Whatever the case may be, it sounded like Mary J. was you know, Mary J. was in violation and she knew that. So something went wrong. It was her fault. And she now she trying to, you know, get things back together. You know what I'm saying? The best way she know how. I ain't going to even say the best way she know how. The way that she know will work for sure. You know what I'm saying? All right, let's keep going. Okay, a little history lesson for you young niggas if you watch this video. What she just did was basically the hip-hop version of what they call scat. You know what I'm saying? I think that Louis Armstrong came up with that term, because the nigga went into the studio to do a record, and he basically just did that on a whole record, and the shit blew up. You know what I'm saying? So, anyway, I don't even know why I got off into that. Some people call that the earliest version of hip-hop, too. But, all right, let's keep it moving. Yo, no, now that I think about it, she may be doing a tribute to like the Ella Fitzgerald, to people like that, the black female singers from that generation of music, you know what I'm saying? Because they used to do that a lot, now that I think of it. I'm just remembering and visualizing the scenes and sounds from the Ken Burns jazz documentary. And they did that a lot, you know what I mean? So maybe she just, you know, paying homage to them on that. Either way, yo, it's Mary J. She's a motherfucking queen. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if that's what she was doing. Because, you know what I'm saying? She royalty up in this motherfucker. Let's keep it moving. All right, man, there it is, yo. Mary J. Blige. So that's her version of All Night Long, son. And it was pretty fucking dope, if I must say so myself. Salute to the queen, son. The queen looks so beautiful in this picture. Like, this is a snapshot of, like, 1994 to me right here, you know what I mean? Like, this is what the 90s boom-bap hip-hop R&B era look like in this picture right here. You know what I'm saying? She got the big door knocker earrings. She ain't got the super big joints, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, she represents, she more, she got more money, you know what I'm saying? She classier with her shit, you know what I'm saying? She got the hat on and shit, face looking immaculate, you know what I'm saying? Hair looking right, you know, just being Mary J up in this motherfucker. I love me some Mary J, my nigga, and I hate R&B. How about that? But anyway, yo, there it is. Shout out to, damn, I forgot who requested this. But yo, shout out to you, my nigga. On to the next one. I'm out.